Sheila, you. Okay, so good morning, everyone. Thanks for coming. So I'll just read off the press statement first, and then if we have any questions, I'll take it. So next to me is Icy from Delicia. Delicia is a social enterprise that helps marginalized and poor women. So maybe after I go through the press statement, then we'll let Icy talk about her project. And then on my left is Kak Zaitun from Masjid Kampung Tunku. Yeah, in SS1. Yeah, Masjid, yeah, Cafe Masjid Kampung Tunku. So I also will let Kak Zaitun explain about it later. So, okay, Perkhidmatan Alun Kampung Tunku will be celebrating Hari Malaysia 2018 with a local twist. So after GE14, it bears repeating again that Dun Kampung Tunku now comprises of the neighbourhoods of SS1, SS2, SS3, SS9A, which is known more as Sungai Wei New Village, Section 20, 21 and 22, which are respectively Taman Paramount here, Sea Park, and also the Taman Aman area. So this year we titled our Sambutan Hari Malaysia as Kampung Tunku, Kampungku, because we wanted to showcase Kampung Tunku's rich history and culture. We want to make Kampung Tunku known as a vibrant and distinct community, and also make Hari Malaysia relevant to the local community. The videos that we've shot are quite interesting, and we'll be showing some of them today. So they include the descendants of the Kapitan Yap Aloy, which are James and his James and his son Glenn Yap, the daughter of the late poet Usman Awang, her name is Mayawati Usman, our Ketua Kampung Baru Sungai Wei, Ding Yao Chai, and also an SS3 born and bred university student, who also interned with us, called Kieran Gill. There will also be a food fair in the basketball next to the hall. We have gathered food from the two pasar malams within Dun Kampung Tunku, which are SS2 and SS3 pasar malams. Cafe Masjid Kampung Tunku will also be selling, I heard, laksa Johor kan, and puff pastry. And Masjid Kampung Tunku will also be providing free barber services. So if you need a haircut for the gentleman, please do come along. The program for the day will showcase talents that come entirely from Dun Kampung Tunku, so homegrown talent. This includes a dance performance by the Pawana Tari dance troupe from SK Kampung Tunku, and also the lion dance from Kuan Lok, Dragon and Lion Dance Association. Yeah, so that's it for the press statement. Maybe I'll let Kak Zaitun introduce about Cafe MKT from Masjid Kampung Tunku.
Okay, I'm Zaitun, one of the crew dekat Cafe Kampung Masjid Kampung Tunku. So actually we are selling all kind of our own product because we attended this training in Mardi, like doing pastry, and then laksa Johor, laksa Penang, and all the Malay kuih lah.
So basically, Cafe MKT, they help the poor women.
All the single mother lah to operate the cafe.
And so last week, we actually visited Masjid Kampung Tunku to talk about the activities. But the ladies actually prepared a surprise for us. So I have tasted the laksa Johor and it's really good. So don't miss out. So Icy, you want to share a bit?
Sure. My name is Icy from Delicia. So what we do is we are a social enterprise that we empower underprivileged ladies, be it about poor families or financial struggling single mom, to bake and cook through catering service. So at this moment, actually, we have around 30 of ladies who are in our team and working closely about 10 people of them. So mostly of them are staying in PPR area, and right now we are working working quite closely with Pesai Damansara as the place that YBOB really put a lot of efforts last time as well. Now, for this Kampung Tunku Kampungku, actually we are sharing over there and we'll be selling some brownie muffins and some sandwiches. So you can come and drop by to have a look and then catch us there because we will be sharing an interview over there also. Yeah, thank you so much.
Okay. Oh yes, we are supposed to launch show two videos also. So the first video we are going to show is the promo video.
How many members do you have?
We do have 1, 2,
servers. The lady Suta is
six.
Ah, yeah,
six.
Okay, what do you make? What are the kind of things you make?
Nasi, like nasi. Our specialty is like puff lah, puff, chicken pie, and then laksa Johor, laksa asam.
When was it formed?
I think about 8 years ago.
Oh, okay. How many of them do you have so far?
Working closely is about 10, but we have a pool of 30. It depends on the food and dishes, what client want. Because sometimes different clients have got different.
As for yours, right, how it has changed their lives for them or how it has helped them?
No, they're quite okay.
Explain to me how were they before?
Before, they're quite, like, let's say that they're quite poor and then the kids are gonna move. I mean, not say when you go to school.
What's the worst case? Like, how many kids she has?
They got like 5.
And she's single mom.
Single mom, yes. Okay.
So after they are part of this program, it is.
Yeah.
One of our
members. Now the her daughter is in university now. Matric.
Okay. Okay.
In Banting.
Okay. So how much can they like make extra?
Because we do catering as well.
So it's an everyday thing, is it? That's very nice.
Yeah.
That's why they have their WhatsApp
group.
And people get into the group and they pull out the menu and people order.
Yeah, people order, Normally we do pre-order.
So you're going to appear on your event there on that day to sell also lah?
We got one booth that's selling puff and laksa Johor and all the frozen food that which we made ourselves.
So
like curry pot pusing or that kind of thing.
So what we want to do through this fair also is to really introduce like the local efforts, especially local efforts that help the community to other locals within the neighborhood. Because if you don't live near Masjid Kampung Tunku or you don't frequent MKT, then you won't know that all these good projects exist.
Yes. But we need to get if more people from outside to come and have our food. No publicity actually. We don't have budget to do
it. It's a social enterprise.
So hopefully maybe can help us.
And as for yours, how
to promote.
If you can tell me how maybe like the worst case that you have and how it has helped her.
The first beneficiary, the makcik we met at LRT is the makcik with 11 kids. Although half of it already grown up, but it's still in the poor cycle. So she's still very struggling. The youngest one is like 11 child. So she still need to struggle and then work hard for it lah. And then one of the story we can tell is Kak Nor, which we just helped last 3 months. It's around February, we engaged by YBOB. So we will teach them to do the Yisam, and then from there we met Kak Nor. And then for the past 3 months, actually we able like to help her to generate about 7K.
Wow.
And then we also very happy and touched when she shared about she shared to us that for many years she haven't have the chance to buy the Raya shirt for her kids. And then this is the first year after many years lah. This year to able to buy it. And then this makes us feel that every efforts we take, although it's a very small step, but it do a lot to all those machi and the machi who have help.
So just to clarify that Delicia mostly operating within the Damansara Bistari but once we finish this event, I think we will have to sit down and see where we can expand.
Yes.
So because in Dun Kampung Tunku there is a PPR and Sri Aman site.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. We see where we can all work together.
Our people are from Sri Aman. Yeah.
that's what is the name of the PPM? I didn't know you all have a PPM.
For ours is Sri Aman.
Sri PPM. Yes. Sri Aman.
Near the Paramount LRT station.
Oh, okay.
They have a flat then? No, I'm a bit confused lah, because next is the condo. The tall building one is
oh, you're right. I know where it is. Yes. Yeah, and there's a nice one there.
Ah, the nice one, yeah. That one is fancy one.
What do you expect out of this event?
I think, you know, we started off with the objective of, you know, really rebranding Dun Kampung Tunku. So at the end of it, if it...
Rebranded what to what?
That's right. You see, the thing is, a lot of people mistake Kampung Tunku with Bukit Tunku. So I keep getting caught, you know, Adun Bukit Tunku, and although, you know, Dun Kampung Tunku holds a lot of important and well-known places in PJ, people don't think of Kampung Tunku when you pass by. So basically, when we talk about rebranding it, it's to brand it as a very distinct community. That's why we actually shot the videos also, and we're doing a photo exhibition, because we wanted to highlight that Dun Kampung Tunku holds some of the oldest neighborhoods in PJ. So the Sekolah Kebangsaan Kampung Tunku in SS1 was officiated by Tunku Abdul Rahman himself. So we will actually be displaying some of the photos. And this area used to be an estate. So we've gotten stories from residents about how life was before and what do they hope for in the future.
These people are still living here? They bought a house and they continue living
here? Yes. So we've had residents stay here, but you know,
1963.
Yeah.
Why did he get the name Kampung Tunku? Do you know?
Why? I haven't actually found the reason, because it used to be estate. I think the SS2 and SS3 area for sure are the estate, like, because SS3 used to be called Seaport. But how it got Kampung Tunku, I'm not really sure if it comes from Tunku Abdul Rahman himself.
But okay,
yeah.
Okay,
thank
you. I'll be
going to say that now.
Their products, you know, in a masjid. You can, the one there, just not in the masjid. That would be good enough. Anyway.